Hello friends, so today we'll be discussing a really interesting question. This is a small derivation, but still I think you'll love it. So let's say I have something here, square or rectangle, whatever. And okay, let me do one construction here. Is that all right? So basically, see, let this be what? Say x, and let this side here till here, okay? Let this be y. And now coming to this small side here, okay? Let this be dx, okay? And coming to this, so yeah, and this small size here, this size, okay. So this is dy. Now you might have guessed what I am trying to do with the power rule, which is the product rule of derivatives. It's a very important rule basically. So let me just write the rule basically. What the rule basically says that if we have ddx of, I mean the derivative is respect to any constant. So let's assume it's x here, okay. Not anyway. Say two things. Say u times v. U multiplied by v. This is a product here. So this is gonna be. This is gonna be. U times. U times ddx of v plus v times ddx of u. Are that clear? Okay. Now, so once I do that, now I want to derive this formula. So let me just wrap this up. Okay? Okay, so basically, you see the area of this part which I'm shading in blue right now. The area of this part here will just be x times y, xy unit square, right? And now you consider the. Now, let's say I have a small error. Small error in x in both x and y in calculating x and y, and so the error in x is okay. Let's say the error in x is dx, and the error in y is dy, which is obviously small. We must assume that the error is small. The error cannot be very big, and then our very basic calculation must be incorrect. So then, what will be the actual area in this case? In this case, you have to consider some additional regions, which I'm just shading up in. Let's say purple. Okay, this region here. Now, what is the area of this purple region? It's gonna be dx. The breadth is dx. So dx times y. Or let me write it more beautifully. I mean, let me write it more like so that it will be easy to understand. So this is gonna be y times dx. The area of this purple part. So now let's choose a different color. Okay. Now let's choose brown. So I'm shading out this region in brown. So the area of this region will be obviously see one. This side is x here. This side is x, and we have this small breadth here, which is dy. So this is gonna be x dy. And what is gonna be this thing here? Okay, this thing. I'm shading it out in green. This small thing you see, this area is gonna be dx times dy. Now the thing is that if the errors are very small. If dx and dy is very small number, the small numbers, then this will tend to 0. This will tend to 0. That's why for you can say for convenience, because in most of the cases that is what it is. We assume this to be 0. So just ignore this part. Just ignore this part. Okay, this green part. Okay, so now look, now we're in a position to write our final equations. Okay. So let me just that means let this entire area. Oh sorry. So this is x y, okay, and this was x dy. So this entire area was originally the entire area was x y, right? Originally the entire area was x y. Now we're trying to take the dd. We're trying to take the derivative of this. Say with some respect to third variable, ddt, let's say. No problem. So this is just gonna be, you see this here, over the extra areas we're gonna add them, right? Y dx plus x, let's say this is xy prime, that's derivative, plus this here x dy. Is that clear? So that's a simple derivation. Plus this thing here also, but as this tends to 0, we just ignore this. Okay, we just ignore this. So that is this is our very simple intuitive idea that from where this formula is coming from, that ddx of x times y is ddt, let's say, x times y dx plus x dy. Even if you take ddt, then also you have to take this derivative using chain rule, you have to take this, so anyway we will get that only. Let me give a simple example what chain rule is, and after that we will be deriving the quotient rule, which is also very important. Okay, so let me just derive this. Before that. Okay, let's just green. Okay, so let me just, show you what the chain rule is. Let's say we have, first of all, if you want to see the derivation of this, you can check it out in my channel. I've already derived this in one of my previous videos using binomial theorem, as far as I can remember, using binomial theorem. So ddx of x raised to the power of n is gonna be just, this is called the power rule, n x to the n minus 1. So just visualize this, this power comes out, so that's why we have an n here, and we subtract 1 from the power, this becomes n minus 1. That's all there is to it. I'll also the derivation here. Okay, so the thing is that this formula we have, ddx of this power rule. So what this formula is really telling me, that there's a power rule. The thing is that we can only apply this rule when the thing here x and the thing here x is the same thing. So now suppose someone has given me, someone has asked me to solve. GdX of sine squared x, or say sine x is whole squared, or let's make it sine cubed. No problem with that. So how will you solve this? So this will not be just the 3 sine 3 minus 1 or 3 sine squared. No, that's the wrong answer. We can't just say this, okay? Because why? Because see, here we have a x. Excuse me. So ddx of sine x. So here we have a x, but here we have a sine x. Here the function is sine x. So if we had dd sine x of sine x cube, then that will be 3 sine x squared. But so how can we write this? We can also write this as, it means the same thing basically. This is nothing but, first of all, we write what we need. We need a sine x here. So dd sine x of sine x cubed. But the thing is that we originally had a dx in the denominator, so we can't ignore the dx. So let's write this dx here. Now to make this equation valid, what should we do? This sine x in the denominator, we're introducing it. So we must multiply it in the numerator also. That is the basic intuition, that's the basic idea. So d sine x here also. Now basically see, these things will cancel, each other out. But obviously we will not cancel them out. That's not the reason why we to consider them. This will cancel each other. So this is the same as this thing here. D of ddx of sine x. Ddx of sine x cube. We have a cube here. Okay. This cube, I think you can make it out. So that's all. Now the thing is that this is all there is to chain rule. Well, some teachers I have seen that they tend to teach this topic chain rule in a complex way. Not required. Not really. This is simply chain rule. You need to make the equation valid, and first of all you need to do this. So once I do this, now I can apply my knowledge. Now what is my knowledge? That dd sine x of sine cube x is gonna be 3, this power will come out. So 3 and sine x raised to the power of 3 minus 1. That is sine x squared or sine square x. So 3 sine square x, but don't forget I have something here also. That is ddx of sine x. Now this also I have already derived. All the trigonometric derivatives of all the trigonometric derivatives are actually derived. So in case you don't know, ddx of ddx of sine x is just, actually the pen is, there is some lag in the pen, so that actually that's why I can't, my handwriting is this bad anyway, so please don't try to mind. I mean, please try not to mind. So this will be, we will have a cos x here. So our final answer will be, this is cos x. So we're just manipulating the equation and solving it, solving these two parts separately. So d dx of sin x cube is 3 sin square x cos x, right? So this is the basic application of chain rule. Anyway, I just wanted to discuss this. Now let's derive the quotient rule. Now the quotient rule is a bit more complex as compared to the product rule. Okay, so let me just, first of all, let me write the quotient rule. D dt of what's the d dx of whatever? U by v, if you have, that's a quotient u by v. U is the numerator, v is the denominator. So this is just v u prime or v d dx of u minus, it's a common thing in mathematics, so there's a division of a minus and multiplication of like a plus. Minus u d dx of v, the whole divided by the square of the denominator, the whole divided by v square. Now, from where is the formula coming from? Now, let's assume we don't know anything, we just want to derive this. So what should be your approach? That can I express this thing here, can I express this thing here as something I already know? The answer is obviously yes, I can do that. Now, what is that you ask me? This is nothing but the, this simple logic. 1 by v is v to the power minus 1. So that means, this implies that u by v is, can be written as u v to the minus 1. Now this is just a product, you see. This is just a product. I have u multiplied by v to the minus 1. Now in this equation, I can apply the product rule. That's how we derive the equation, basically. So what we had basically is that, okay, so let's have this expression. Dt of u v raised to the power minus 1. That's the dt of u by v. So if I apply the product rule, what will I get is u dt of v raised to the minus 1 plus, I'm just applying the product rule here, okay, plus v raised to the minus 1 dt of u. Now my question is, can we apply chain rule here? Obviously. So obviously we can't take the derivative of v, means, here we don't have any t term, so that means we have to write this as d over dv of v raised to the minus 1, okay, times dv over dt. Now my question is, what is dv over dt? Like we can't find that out, we don't have any information, so let this remain as it is. And what is dv of v raised to the minus 1? Here we can apply this power rule, right, here we can apply the power rule. So this will just give you minus 1 will come out. And we have minus 1 v raised to the power minus 1 minus 1. 1 subtract from the power. That's minus 2. So minus 1 v raised to the minus 2. Now what is this expression here? Minus 1 v raised to the minus 2. This is the same as minus v raised to the power minus 2. That is just 1 over v square. So minus 1 over v square. Right. So that's all I have here. So this is going to be u. And this is, so we have a minus here, that's minus u by v square, minus 1 over v square, and we will have a dt of v. See, actually, I just did the derivation yesterday, but that's why. That's why I just remember that if you take this, it will not be of any help. So for now, let's keep this as minus v to the minus 2, okay. For now, let's keep it like this. It will be helpful later on. You'll see why. And we will have a u here. And then this will be just d dt of v, right, plus, okay, now you try to think of this expression, so v raised to the minus 1, let's keep this as v raised to the minus 1 for the time being, v raised to the minus 1, and d dt of u, there is nothing much we can do with that, so let's just keep it like that only, d dt of u, because you can't apply chain rule here, right, here we apply chain rule because v raised to the minus 1, we could have done something with that, but d dt of u simply, we can't do anything with it. Unless you know the, you can't do anything with it, with this information. Unless you have some, unless you know what u is in terms of t, you can't do it, right? So now you have this expression here, okay? So let me just wrap this, this thing here. Okay, so now, is there anything that you can take common from this thing? Yes. V raised to the minus 1. Because V raised to the minus 2 can be written as v raised to the minus 1 times v raised to the minus 1. Okay, because the powers will just add up, that will give you v raised to the minus 2. So that means if we take v raised to the minus 1 common, what will we get? We get minus u, and v raised to the minus 1 will remain because it's from here. Minus u raised to the minus 1 dt of v plus dd of u, right? So that's what we have. Okay, so now I'm just dropping this here. So now let's try to simplify this expression. So v vector minus 1 is just 1 by v, and I will just write this here. Okay, I mean I just tried this previously, and I just write this here. Okay, no problem with that. So ddt of u, we have a minus here, note that. So minus u, v vector minus 1 is just u by v. Okay, this is just gonna be u by v. U by v times ddt of v. We end up with this sort of expression. My question is, how can we relate this with the expression we originally had? Our original expression was v ddx of u minus u dd, v ddt of u minus u ddt of v whole divided by v square. Okay, so let's see. So we have taken this common v vector minus 1, and we had a v vector minus 1 here. So this will be, yeah, obviously this will be u by u minus v. Okay. I understand the problem. So actually, see, I will not cancel this video because I actually did a mistake. I didn't really mistake, but the problem, that is the thing with mathematics. You try different approaches. There is not a single way to reach destination, but still you try different approaches and figure out which is the best for you. Actually, it would have been better if we had done something else. If we had taken minus two common. Let's see why that's gonna help us. So this is the expression we had, right? So if we take v to the minus two common, let's see how this will help us. Then we get minus u ddt of v plus here please note we have v raised to the minus 1, but we are taking v raised to the minus 2 common. That means it will be, what will it be? So that means you need to multiply something such that in that case you have taken v raised to the minus 2 common, you have taken 1 by v squared common, right? Understand it simply, if you can, like you have taken 1 by v squared common, and in the inside you have 1 by v, right? So you need 1 by v in the v square. So 1 by v square into v will give you that. So in that case, we just have v here. You understand the logic. 1 by v square multiplied by v will give you 1 by v. And 1 by v is what you need here, v raised to minus 1. But you have taken 1 by v square common. So you need to have a v here, just v here. Okay. So I hope you got the logic. There are numerous ways to understand that. If you are comfortable with some other logic, you can go with that. So v ddt of u. So now you see why we have that expression. Yeah, our previous approach was not wrong. Mathematically, it was correct. So we could have discovered some new formula for this quotient rule. But yeah, this is the simplest formula, and it looks more beautiful, most easy to use. That's why we use this. That's all. So now I can just write this previously, and I can just write this after. So all I will get is v ddt of u minus, we have a minus here, okay? Minus u ddt of v. And the whole divided by, okay, I don't know, spaces I'm writing it like this, the whole divided by v raised to the minus 2. So this, if I bring this in denominator, it will just become v raised to the plus 2, that's just v square, the whole divided by v square. So that's a beautiful derivation of the quotient rule. And once we know how to write the product rule, that needed some visualization, right? This, all these things. So once we know how to write that is, then deriving the quotient rule isn't something great. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this video, and that's all for today's video. Thank you very much. Thanks for watching.